So, welcome everybody to our one-shot awesome mouse guard campaign. Bear has graciously agreed to host a mouse guard game. I've never played this game before. It's basically a fantasy RPG where you play as mice rather than people. So everything is smaller. And you're fluffy. And you have one of those... Anyway, they're mice. You get the idea. So, Bear, if you want to kind of lead us in, that's probably best. I'm just kind of talking out my ass at the start here, and you know, just to sort of mark the beginning of my recording.
Okay. So, obviously, as Elf said, in this game you play mice, and you are all members of the Mouse Guard, which does a lot of jobs to protect the mouse territories, simply called the territories. Stuff like escorting, fighting off predators, pathfinding, making trails for the other mice to go along, delivering mail, all of that. So these four intrepid, hopefully surviving mice will be doing a little one-shot mission, indeed, which you shall see soon. Now, onto the character introductions. Let's just go from left to right on Elf's screen, so you can call them out.
So me, then Rack, then Pig, then Phoenix. Rack, you're kind of doing this thing right now, Rack, where you're like, your face is like...
I'm looking at the book.
Okay. I was just making sure you're kind of aware
computer anyway.
Of...
we're good.
I need a thing on the character list.
All right. So, yeah. I'm going to go first.
Type it into the chat, and I'll put it in.
We're going to introduce our characters, the mice that we will be playing in this particular session. My character is Abernathy. He is a guard mouse who uses a spear as a weapon. He's a nocturnal mouse, however, so he is constantly tired and sleepy during the day. So, you know, that gets him into a little bit of trouble sometimes. But he's a loyal member of the, you know, mouse guard and so forth, and I'm looking forward to playing him. Rack! Why don't you tell us about Randall?
I am Rock Voss, and as always, I am here playing because I'm cool. I play Randall, who is a white mouse, a red cloak, carries a sword, and he is basically a grizzled veteran of a much more tumultuous time, which was called the Weasel Wars. And basically, due to his experiences of being like a fresh recruit in the Weasel Wars, he has become a grizzled veteran who tries to make sure that none of the people in his charge as a patrol leader ever get injured, and he's kind of one of those overbearing, overprotective father types.
Fair enough.
With no emotion.
With no emotion.
He's the Terminator, but he's like fatherly Terminator.
The fatherly Terminator.
I'm going to protect you with my gun.
All right, Pig. Why don't you tell us about a little bit about Allern?
So I play Allern. He is a bit of a hunter and a survivalist who specializes in living mostly out in the wilderness. His parents were boat crafters. His mentor was an insectarist. So he's got plenty of interesting skills to play with. And he definitely has a good sense of weather. He's quick-witted because he spends a lot of time trying to survive in the wilderness.
Lovely. And last but not least, Phoenix, why don't you tell us about Tinkleton?
All right, my character's name is Tinkleton. He is a tenderpaw, so he just got out of the academy. He is a little bit full of himself, maybe too full of himself. He likes to fight and believes he can take anything on. He's pretty fearless. But because of that and because, you know, times are hard, he kind of accumulated a lot of debt. And we're going to see how that plays into the story because that's going to be fun. And his best friend's name is Jesse, and his mentor is actually Abernathy, played by Elf.
Yeah, I get to be the mentor for somebody, which is terrible because my character is in no way a good mentor. And of course, Bear.
Yep, I am your, GM today, and, I don't know, I've been playing Mouse Guard for a little bit, but I've GM'd before, but it's been a while, so bear with me. No.
Bear.
I know. I said it in the chat, and I didn't notice until afterwards.
And that's, you know, that's fine. Bear, basically, we were all bored today, so we're like, what can we do? And Bear's like, I can run Mouse Guard. And we were like, okay. So so now she's running Mouse Guard. Hit us. Hit us, okay. Bear. Lead us in.
All right. So you four have been contacted by the leader in Lockhaven, Gwendolyn. She has a mission for you, and she contacted Randall, the patrol leader, and he, of course, was supposed to be picking out a patrol, you know, hand-picked mice for this mission, and obviously you're all picked, or else I would have made him. And after all of you have been collected, you have gotten all of your supplies, you now need to go meet her in her little room.
So we're going to meet Gwendolyn?
In her map room. Gwendolyn, yes.
Okay. So we're all, like, summoned, basically.
You are all summoned.
Okay.
For this mission. You don't know what it is yet, but you've gotten all of your little traveling supplies, so you assume
got
it's...
my little mousy backpack.
Yes.
Awesome. Alright, so I guess we head to the room. You can't ignore a summon from the leader of Lockhaven, so...
Of course not.
Let's go.
Alright. As you enter, you see Gwendolyn, a little blonde mouse, leaning over a table, a big map of the territories all over there. Unmarked. And she looks at you four and says, I need you to start patrolling a trail between the towns of Rootwallow and Barkstone. A grain peddler has gone missing, and you need to find him.
Randall, somebody's gone missing?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
How long ago did he go missing?
We just got word yesterday, so it shouldn't have been too long. We don't know where he is. There's been no sign of him, but that's what you're here for.
All right. First day out of the academy, and we already have a fun job. Are we going to fight a snake? Are we going to fight an owl? What are we going to fight?
Hey.
Said she had maps around her.
Yep, she has maps of the territories on her table.
Can you show me on this map around about the area we should be searching?
Okay, hold on, my GM layer is getting in the way of me actually looking at everything on the map. There we go.
1 second, my roll 20 just went down.
Oh, okay. I'll give you a second.
No, you can keep going.
Barkstone. Just gonna find Rootwallow.
There we go.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, you back? Good.
Yeah, I'm back.
Objects and tokens, so I can rule her properly. Between here and here. That is the...
Uncharted territory.
So it's most likely along these roads. He wouldn't have gone off trail.
Jesus, that's a lot of place.
Are there any other patrol leaders looking?
No, we've tasked, you with this since it only happened recently, but if it goes any longer, we might send another one out to help you.
Alright. Okay.
Right. Let's move out.
Alright,
Yes, sir!
I need to speak with you afterwards? Or, I need to speak with you now after the others have left.
Ma'am.
Alright.
Come on, boys, let's go. Get ready to leave.
It's dismissed.
Will we be getting any money for this?
She kind of rolls her eyes a little and says, you're in the Mouse Guard. This is your job. You will get paid, but know that you're doing this for reasons other than money.
I'm gonna give Tinkleton the stink eye. Just like, are you serious, man? Come on.
Run on donations alone, basically.
Yeah.
Axes or tits.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe this grain.
This isn't for material gain. We're doing this to protect the territory.
We gotta save that mice. That grain merchant.
Look,
grain peddler,
guys,
bro.
Guys, I'm in very big debt right now, so you know, I gotta get money where I can.
Have you been gambling again?
Sort that out on your own terms, Tenderpaw. Now,
I don't have a problem.
If you'll excuse us, I need to talk with Randall.
Fine.
Alan Tingleton, Let's give him some space, I guess.
As Alarn is leaving, he's like, his hands are like this, and he looks like really nervous. He's like, maybe he's lost. It's a lot of space, and it's not very easy to survive out there.
All right. Once Gwendolyn and Randall are alone, she stares at the map for a second and then glances back at him. The grain peddler, we suspect he might be a spy selling secrets about Lockhaven. I need you, once you find him, to determine if this is true or not.
And how would you like me to do so, ma'am?
Look for evidence, if there is any on him. Try to interrogate him. Any way you can find out if he's been selling secrets, it has to be on paper somewhere, so whatever's on him, I suppose.
Dear diary.
And where does this mouse reside?
He lives in Barkstone, or he lived in Barkstone before he went missing, and he used to move between the two towns, Root Wallow and that, with his grain.
If at all necessary, so, send another patrol leader to Barkstone to check his inhabitants, in case I may not find anything.
Mm-hmm. And if you don't, well, I would instruct you to head to Barkstone afterwards to investigate there.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Okay. He'll flourish his cloak and do a deep bow to the matriarch and excuse himself.
Right. She smiles and waves you off.
Whoosh. Turn. I like it.
All right. So you guys have to find the grain peddler between Barkstone and Root Wallow. Now, it's time for you to get to your own personal goals for this.
Indeed.
Which I need to write down as well to keep track of. All right. Now you need to think of a goal for this.
I think Abernathy's personal goal for the mission is going to be preventing Tinkleton from doing anything stupid.
Okay.
Tinkleton's goal is to do as much stupid shit as he wants, like fighting as much as he can.
Okay. So.
So Tinkleton's goal is basically to have as much action as possible in his first mission.
Pretty much. What he a wants dick. It to be memorable.
Okay. What a dick.
We find a hawk.
Impress your mentor. Impress your mentor.
Gain
the attention of your mentor.
Gain a cloak, goddammit.
Okay. Randall.
I guess my goal is to prevent the injury of any of my charges.
Okay.
That work?
One of our goals is to actually find the son of a bitch.
Okay. Because if I accomplish it. Yay for me. I'm hoping no one gets hurt. That's not including myself, by the way. That's just including the...
Okay, so just everybody else makes it out safe.
Find something to fight. To map out any key resources along the way, including finding out where this grain cart is, because the grain cart's more important than this guy.
Oh! Okay. Along the way... All right. Sweet.
He's a major like survivalist.
Got
he's
got
to find all the good foods.
Looking he's for awesome. The grain and also the berries and also the everything else.
he's got like all of his points are in like hunting, scouting, and survivalist. So he's just looking for all the good stuff.
I can't get.
I'm gonna just find all the good stuff.
That Randall picture is. I can't get. It's an amazing mouse picture.
Oh, yeah, that one? It's pretty great.
Can't get over it.
All right. So,
Yep.
Yeah.
So, Randall's dismissed from Gwendolyn's room there. And the rest of us are kind of, like, gearing up and getting ready to go, because, hey, we're Mouse Guard, and we gotta, you know, do our job and stuff.
We gotta guard some mouses.
We gotta mouse some guards, man.
Sitting there going, maybe I'll find a snake.
Yep.
I'll find... some weasels to kill.
Listen, man.
Like,
you don't
want to
find.
Imagining.
You don't want to find any of those things.
According to some of the mice at the gate, instructed to have you see you out. You are to head to Root Wallow and then head west to Barkstone to cover that trail.
Pink, stop eating your damn chips. I can hear them like a chips. Fucking mile away.
And good. If I have not mentioned already, it is fall.
Okay.
11:52. And the weather is pretty clear and crisp, so from the look of the sky, you don't foresee anything catastrophic.
Okay, so, are we making our way to Rudewallow, or are we going, like, to the other place that barks stuff?
You're first to head to Rootwallow, and then to just cover all of that. Yep.
Okay, so we're headed to Rootwallow, then we're making our...
headed to where he's supposed to, be, and then basically just backtrack from there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. That sounds perfect.
All right.
I love my crispers.
So, mm-hmm. If we're making our way to Rudewallow, I guess we're headed down the well-established trails that lead between Rockhaven and Rudewallow. I don't know. Everybody else can chime in, but I guess, you know, we set off as soon as possible, I imagine.
Yeah, I'm assuming so, unless any of you have any...
I'm too excited. I don't even. Okay. If I leave something behind, I don't care. I'm too excited.
Let's do
this.
I
have everything like meticulously packed before we've even left. My stuff was already.
I just say that it's. He's gonna be very sad if he's going down these trails and nothing happens.
Although
like, this is my first mission.
I will say that at this moment, Tinkleton is like freaking out, Ellen. Because he's like, oh, we find like a snake, and he's like, I don't want to bite anything. Like,
no. Dude, stop inviting bad things to happen.
No.
I'm staying basically to the middle of the pack the whole time, and like, you know, head on a swivel.
As I'm the scout, I'll be moving ahead as much as possible and just like checking the path ahead of us. Maybe like a couple of group lengths, sort of like away, up in front.
Can I use predator-wise in the area to see what kind of predators are around?
Yeah, roll it. And this is as you're making your way to Rootwallow.
Yeah.
All right. you know that this close to Lockhaven, there aren't usually a lot of predators in the area, or any that pose a significant threat to any of the mice around here. And there haven't been word, according to any of the other garden mice, of any... you know, uprisings, you know, snakes, kestrels, anything in the area thus far.
Wanted to make sure we weren't going to run into a badger.
Okay.
You don't actually know. Especially not this close to Lockhaven.
So we're probably okay kind of going there.
Yeah.
So
you make your way to Rootwallow without much incident. You know, you pass a few mice along the way. They give you the old nod.
The old nod.
No trouble. No word of bandits and the like. So you make your way to the town fairly easily, and there you are at the start of your tracking.
I'm going to check the whole town to see if he may have arrived in the meantime as we're traveling.
All right. You see no word of him. They've seen neither hide nor hair. Of him in several days, around the same time frame that Gwendolyn gave you.
What kind of town is Rootwallow? Like, how big is it? Like, what does it do?
It's fairly small. Hold on.
You're a small town.
I just kind of want a mental image, you know? Like, you don't need to give me the whole spiel.
It looks a root, and people wallow in it.
It's a very, Well, according to the name, it's in the roots of a tree. It's a fairly small town. It's not as significant as, say Lockhaven. But it's a family, home to a family of silk harvesters. It's very, very small.
Okay.
Barely of note. It's not.
So it wouldn't take us a long time to, like, search it, basically.
Definitely not. There's not a lot of people
here. And if they haven't heard of the person, then we're probably good. Like.
Yeah, word travels fast. You can pretty much,
There's only...
trust that he wouldn't have gone through this town unnoticed.
Mm-hmm. There's only two houses.
They're both very, each very other. Few.
Randall would probably check through all their provisions to make sure they have all the proper things ready, obviously with his meticulous planning. So he would, you know, immediately sit down your packs. We need to check provisions.
Hey man, you tried to steal my stuff.
Aller in the black mouse.
It's just...
Hey, man!
Abernathy just shrugs his pack off and, like, puts it down in front of him. He's like, be my guest, man. If you want to check through it, that's fine.
Alan, we've been through this enough times, Alan, that you should know by now.
I'm Abernathy.
I need to make... No, Alan. He was the one who was like, yeah, you're trying to steal my stuff.
You're right.
I know what I'm doing here, Elf.
Alan is just someone who's so meticulous and paranoid, essentially, about everything. He's like, are you gonna steal my stuff?
I'm just checking to make sure we have the proper provisions. This is a long trip, and I don't want to have any problems on the way.
I've counted everything I have in there, so I'm pretty sure I have everything. You can double check, but I'm just gonna make sure that everything's there when you're done.
You might as well let him check it, Alan. I mean, it's just faster if you do.
All right, checking the stuff. Checking the stuff.
Yeah, Randall pulls out like a little scrap of paper and, you know, piece of charcoal and like starts like writing down provisions. You know, in that being that meticulous, you know, make sure everything's properly planned for.
All right. Just tell me when y'all want to leave.
Is this something that's gonna take like a couple minutes? Rack, you think Randall like checking through all
probably,
the packs?
Yeah.
Abernathy looks for the nearest shady spot and just like sits down like.
Because okay. Randall would be like, all right, yeah, we have two water skins, two small rations in this pack, and then he would just like write down everybody's stuff. Slip the list back into his cloak.
All right, you find that you have more than enough supplies to last you all the way to Barkstone, and then a little bit back, but you can pick some up on the way. I mean, there are some guards stationed in, you know, some of the other towns that are, and other citizens that are willing to give you some supplies, you know.
I mean, Randall also has a shit ton of resources, so I mean...
Yeah, you have enough. Do not worry.
Lots of resources.
I can buy a small business. I didn't realize.
If how many resources do you have?
Look, Rack. Why don't you just buy? Why don't you just buy Root Wallow?
You could, but I'm not gonna let you.
Like this is my house. Get out. Right, so after that, basically, he'll be ready to leave. You know.
All right.
Everyone same, else? Same. I'm basically napping until Randall like kicks me and wakes me up.
Alan is just kind of like pacing, and he's half worried about the fact that somebody's looking through his stuff, but he's also like, we don't have time for this. We need to keep going. I mean, with this person, like, what happens if someone takes their food? Well, I mean, we could definitely eat the food if we find it. But...
Tinkleton's just on the side swinging his halberd around, still going, I can't wait to fight something.
He's just, like, super eager.
Oh, my God.
Abernathy just with, like, the little bubble, you know?
Yeah.
sleeping.
I'll walk over and, you know, nudge Abernathy awake.
We good to go?
Have I bored you long enough? Let's move out.
He doesn't even bother to, like... come back. He just picks himself up. He's like, we've worked together before, right? It's sort of Randall and Abernathy. So
Tinkleton would be the only new one to the group.
Yeah.
So I'm used to the lethargic way you do things.
Indeed, and but I'm useful at night, man. I'm awake like during the night.
I don't know how familiar Alarn would be with everybody. He tends to spend most of his time alone.
Okay.
In the wilderness.
Yeah, he was probably in like a couple of things like. If you're with this group, you've probably been on a couple of missions.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're headed off then?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And he sort of picks himself up, goes over, gets his bag, and like gets ready to head out again.
All right. So you head along. The trail is well worn. A lot of tracks, but you wouldn't be able to identify, you know, the grain peddler just from little mouse feet.
However, I am a lore mouse, and if they are the tracks of things I may know about, I might be able to discern what they are the tracks of. So let's roll some die. Two successes for lore mousing.
All right. Well, you can definitely spot the tracks of, you know, the straight tracks of wheels going from carts and, you know, little mouse feet here and there. And you can tell that rather recent, and while this path isn't as well used as, say, some between Shaleborough and Lockhaven, mm-hmm. this was, you're definitely on the right trail.
Okay, we're definitely headed in the right direction.
Yeah, and someone with a cart has used this quite recently.
I'm going to. Sorry. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Does it look like there's any like struggling with the cart or something? As if like he's in a hurry. Someone that maybe like hunting might, you know, tell if there was a like he was in danger or something. Tracks on the ground.
Not that you can see. No.
Okay.
Yeah, I of course relate all this information to the group as we're going. I'm like, somebody's been through here with a cart just recently.
Alright, as you're heading, you get to Copperwood. And does anyone want to stop there, or shall I keep going?
I don't care about Copperwood.
What's in Copperwood? You guys are
fucking rushing. We'll fucking know what's in Copperwood.
I know what's in fucking Copperwood.
Copper and wood.
Yeah. Copper and
it's in the name, man.
All I have to say is like maybe really comfy beds.
Shut up.
You're on a mission. You don't have time to sleep.
Yeah. Where we're going. Well,
one of my instincts is like always know where the next good meal is coming from. So.
Oh, is it?
So good
right
food.
Now, that's your that's rations, great. Boy.
Yeah. You've got lambus bread. Get over it.
You got lambus.
Get it because you're an elf. Zing.
No.
Alright, so, okay, let's keep going then. If everybody else wants to keep going, I'm not going to drag things down by...
Alright, as you're making way to Elmos, you come across a small group of, travelers. They seem, little caravan people. Little caravan people doesn't describe them as well. They,
Well, little caravan mice.
Little caravan mice, of course, I'm sorry. Have their cart full of goods. They look like they're heading over to Copperwood to transport some of their stuff, but otherwise they don't look suspicious, but they seem like they might know anyone who would come past here.
They're like frequent travelers.
Yeah, so very frequent. They are not one is the little map open.
I'll take the lead and walk up to them. Excuse me. Have you seen a grain peddler come by here by any chance?
A grain peddler? How long ago are you looking for?
How many days has it been?
It's been about 3 in total since he was last seen.
It was about 3 days ago we got word that he was missing and we're looking for him currently.
Oh, okay. Let's see, Felix, where is he? I just saw him just yesterday. He went, that way, and he actually points in the direction you are traveling to Barkstone. It says, he's the grain peddler that goes between Barkstone and Rootwallow, right? Just back and forth? Yeah, I saw him a few days ago. He passed by without a word, didn't really seem much like talking.
It seems odd for a grain peddler who normally stops and talks to a lot of people.
But don't really share a word, you know, I've seen him a lot, but he seemed to be in a little bit of a hurry this time, I don't know why.
Thank you for your time.
No problem. Let's carry on to Copperwood.
If he was in a hurry, Randall, shouldn't we get a move on?
Alaryn comes running up. He's like, "Well, if we might not get him. If he gets away, we should keep going quickly." And he's like tugging on like Abernathy's like clothes. Like, come on, you said we should go.
Just like
Abernathy is more of the tired mouse, while Alaryn's more of the hyperactive. Let's go.
He's quick-witted. He doesn't have patience. He's
just
like,
keep going. Pushing him off my green cloak. He's like, hey, bitch, don't touch me.
Paranoid and impatient, the perfect combination.
Paranoid and impatient.
All right. Let's move out then.
Move out? All right.
Yes, boss. And Abernathy, takes the up-ahead scout style.
When we Alaryn falls to the back, and he's kind of bringing up the behind, like, keep an eye out behind him, you know. Looking at, like, pretty flowers and mushrooms that might be edible.
When we get to Elmos, I will, I'll reprovision us and get more food.
Gotcha. So. And, if you happen to ask around for the grain peddler, they have seen him. He stopped here very, very recently, the same time period. And he was headed off. He picked up and went. He didn't stay for too long, didn't talk to anyone. Oh yeah, you got your resources. You're stocked up.
Plus one for hometown.
Plus one for hometown, you know.
We're so stocked up, we can't carry it all.
The mice you meet there, you know, welcome you back.
Can I
yes.
do a scout check to see if I can find the mouse?
Yes.
Oh, wow. My hometown is actually Copperwood.
You're going to make a scout test, and you'll need... Okay.
I only have one success of four.
All right. Roll. I gotta roll something, too. Let me just see what... Okay. You can see his tracks, but you cannot find him right now.
Okay, am I, like, too far behind, or is it just disappeared? Like,
oh, they're just disappeared somewhere. You see some, what wises do you have?
Huh? I have a tall grass wise, and, what was my other wise? I took another wise. Night wise.
Okay. Is Randall with you?
I was scouting, so probably okay. not immediately, but I'd be standing where the tracks ended and be like, hey, you know.
Okay. You see the overturned grain cart, grain spilled everywhere. That's what you find. And there's a little bit of a frenzied mouse tracks, like scuffle, and then a long score mark, like not exactly a track. Let me draw that. I don't know
like
how to
like something
it.
Had been drugged?
Yeah, like something had been drugged along into the off the path and into
something
the grass.
Something has been drugged into the grass.
Is it tall grass?
Amru Hifnal.
Is it tall grass? Do I know?
It's not tall grass.
I mean, wouldn't all grass be pretty much tall, though?
Randall, give me predator wise.
Predator wise. Alright.
I mean, I gotta think. If there's no humans around or anything, who's the one cutting the grass? Wouldn't everything be like tall grass?
That's a snake track.
Snake!
Yes! Snake. We get to fight a snake! Oh.
Okay with snakes.
Yep.
Let's go, garden.
It leads a little farther off that way, but.
While we're standing by the grain, the overturned grain cart, and our, mm-hmm. you know, Randall's examining the sort of marking on the ground that mentions a snake, I guess. Mm-hmm. Are you sharing that information with us? Rack, or are you just, like, sort of,
Kind of, like, I wouldn't want to panic any of the people, and knowing that Alern is very finicky.
Yes.
so I would probably, you know, take a moment to, like, decide what we're going to do next, because if it's already been 3 days and there's a snake track with an overturned grain cart, we might have already been too late in the first place.
Mm-hmm. What I was going to say is, like, Abernathy's looking at the grain cart and going, like, well, this is probably, you know, his cart, so, I think we're basically done here.
Tenderpaw, talking to Tinkleton.
Sir!
Take that cart, put it back upright, and fill it with the grain. Okay. Once you're finished, we move out.
Yeah, get on that.
Alern has like a piece of grain and he's like, it's dirty, oh god. So Tinkleton goes over and is like, okay, my first job by Randall. I have to do this right.
Sure.
Yeah. Okay.
Do you have a job laborer? Because that would
I don't have anything with jobs. Let me collect all the ants. Maybe we can overturn this cart.
Now we can...
The cart itself, you're able to lift, but the grain everywhere. Starts spilling everywhere.
Oh, and, you're doing! Oh, God.
Not
that's
that it matters.
That's why I said fill it back up.
Making a mess.
Fill it back up. And you spot a rolled up piece of parchment within the grain that spills up. Almost like
Randall,
it was just
this isn't supposed
buried
to be
within.
I want to pick it up and read it.
All right. Okay, that hidden in the grain cart, it's a very detailed map of Lockhaven. Like, extremely detailed. No one should be in possession of this other than the mouse, higher ranking mouse guard officials.
My god, Randall's house is on here. I better give this to him. He comes running over like, I think I found this. It might not be something good for other people to have. Here.
I'll take one look at it and immediately, you know, remember what the matriarch told me. Ah, thank you very much, Lern. This will come in handy later on, but first we need to find this grain peddler and see what may have come of him.
What the cart? The cart. I don't want to leave it there. Someone might steal it.
You still see how me on the ground?
Why?
Shoveling the grain.
Just get Tinkleton to take it. He can. He's a strong young mouse. I'm sure he can pull it just fine.
I trust that the mice of Elmos will be able to take care of this cart just fine. We need to move out as quickly as possible.
Righto, boss.
Yeah. It's my hometown. I have so much love for them.
Abernathy, once again, just like picking himself up and leaning on a spear and going, so, where are we going?
Well, first of all, we need to find this grain peddler. And from the looks of those tracks, and I'll point to the tracks to say, it's time we hunt. Scout the way, Abernathy.
Righto.
Righto, he's British now.
Well,
Righto, then.
Righto. Anybody.
I'm gonna scout the way up.
Hey, anybody can say righto. You shut up. I say righto all the time. Anyway,
it's
righty ho.
So righty ho.
Righty ho.
Anyway, so he follows the like if he can, and I can use pathfinding or scouting, depending
scout.
On what you
it would need scout
want,
and,
Bear.
You know, anyone with scout can also assist you. But.
Yes. Does anybody else have scout?
I can assist.
Okay. How will you assist?
I do not.
I will
narratively.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're looking for paths on which they go.
Well, I'm like following the groove that the snake may have left in the
groove,
in the grass.
You
know? Of course, being a expert like hunter, and somewhat of a pretty good scout, I'll be kind of like maybe 2 or 3 feet away from him, like looking at the ground. Like I think there's a path over here. I think it's going this way. What do you think? Just keep.
Yeah, and he's like checking over and being like, oh, no, it's not. The grass is not broken over there, or like, oh, it looks like it's over there.
Hunting
so, yeah.
skills would come in
like
quite
that.
Handy for seeing where
mm-hmm.
predators have gone.
All right, add another die to that roll. So just roll one more.
Me or
you, yeah.
Okay.
It, yeah, helping adds a die to your roll, yeah.
Okay.
One die.
Yeah!
Sadly, right. Not a success.
All right.
No!
Well,
I'm not listening to you, you crazy bastard.
Listen, man, I do this in my own time. Just chill.
We need to hurry. He might be dead.
Okay, well,
Me and Alan causing more problems for each other than we're solving.
That helps
like...
perfectly, because while you did not reach the number of successes needed, you find the little, what seems to be an entrance to a little snake den, a hole in the ground. However, the entire ordeal has made both of you angry.
We're
check
bothered.
Out that angry condition.
Look, man, I don't have time to deal with your shit right now.
Yeah, both of you are pretty angry.
Okay,
hey, but we'd be here quicker if you would have just listened to me and kept going.
So what
no.
does angry do for us, Bear, or not do for us?
Let me see.
As such.
It's a -1 to dispositions for any conflict that uses will as its base. So it'll come up when you have a conflict.
Okay.
But that's about it.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
So yeah. The others will be coming in a little behind us, I guess, behind
yeah.
the sort of scout party. And we're standing at the mouth of this snake hole.
Mm-hmm.
I turn to Randall as he approaches with Tinkleton and say, boss, I don't know if you... want to go searching down there. Doesn't look like a very hospitable environment.
It looks fine. Let's get going.
Okay. I was going to roll predator-wise to see, like, based on the size of the hole, how many snakes there may be in it, but 0 successes is awesome.
Snakes
you
are...
you do not know.
Yeah.
You know it's a snake hole, but you don't know how many snakes are in the snake hole.
Snake hole.
That is,
can I
that
roll
is awesome.
A...
that is awesome. You have no clue.
A hunting to see if any other snakes have come through by this hole or not? Like tracking how many different paths there are around it, snake trails.
Well, from elf scouting, you only spotted one set of tracks so far.
Okay.
So far. A single route in and out. Yeah.
Come on, we're mice.
Else?
We're mice of the guards. We can do this. We can go down there and fight.
Hold your tongue, Tinkleton.
Yes, sir.
Randall, kind
shut
of
up,
like,
bitch.
Kind of like shut find up, the nearest bitch. Nearest small rock and mm-hmm. and sit down and maybe like ponder the situation. Like, if we go in there and we're not properly prepared,
Randall just takes a seat.
Yeah, if we go in there and we're not properly prepared, I may lose one or two of my charges.
Takes the cue of sitting like, down to sit down himself.
Ellerin, still being angry, is like pacing now. He's like, why are we wasting so much time? People are probably dead. Ah!
Tickleton's standing in front of the snake hole, just looking down, like, I dare you to come up, bitch. I dare
you. He's got his halberd out, like, waiting.
Randall,
that is perfect.
I'll cut you. I'll cut you.
This escalation of group is just driving Ellerin crazy.
It's like, come on, fight me. Like, no, don't do that, you crazy bastard. But we need to figure out what's going on, and nobody's doing anything.
Randall will hop up and draw his sword and start moving towards the hole.
Okay. Tinkleton, since he is standing closest to the hole, can start to hear, is Alern there too?
Alern's pacing, like, yelling at himself.
Yeah. he'd be more towards where Randall was sitting. Okay. Like, maybe halfway in between him and the hole, like, why are we not doing something?
Well, Tinkleton starts to hear movement from the hole, you know, displacing.
Guys.
Sounds like we have company.
Abernathy's gonna grab his spear and stand up at least, so he's like, you know, somewhat prepared.
All right.
Tinkleton's gonna back a little way from the hole just so he can give the snake some room.
Who has fighter skill? I know Tinkleton does.
Not me.
Does Abernathy or Learn have any fighter?
I have no fighter. Zero fighter.
Okay. Zero fighter.
Since I know Learn the best, and Abernathy the best, even though Tinkleton is more fighter, I would tell them, Learn, Abernathy, stand to either side of this hole. I'll go in and draw it out so we have more room to fight this beast.
I have a better idea. We can shove
you
a
hear.
Rock
it sounds like it's coming out. If you're close to the hole,
Abernathy makes no delay in sort of like responding to the commands of his patrol leader. You know, when it comes to a dangerous situation, he's like ready to go.
I'm the grizzled man. I know what I'm doing. Right?
You know, he has his spear in his hands and he's sort of pointing it towards the hole, like sort of upward and to the left of the hole. You know, like wanting to get the top of the head.
Ellerin's like. Okay, but I'm not gonna get hurt by this. And he's standing near the hole with his bow, like, drawn, but he's, like, three or four steps back.
Shoot him in the eye.
Alright.
Tinkleton, stand alert. Today, you'll be tested. And I'll start heading into the hole with the sword out, like... Because I want the snake to focus on me when it comes out of the hole, so it won't see... The comrades on either side.
So you're just like standing at the middle of the hole, like, come and get me, bitch.
And so those two are on the side. Am I like behind you a little ways?
Yeah.
Or, like...
Yeah, probably. So you would like, you would basically be an intermediary. Remember, like, as soon as it comes out, they'll see it.
Remember that, like, we don't need to worry too much because the combat is like narrative. You know what I mean?
Combat is very narrative. Yeah. All right.
I want to kick this bitch's ass.
So you don't get too far into the hole until you see, you know. Snake face.
Okay.
Right up there.
So you can see how snake-like I can really be.
You're far.
Soon as I see that, basically, I'll let it see me, mm-hmm. obviously, and then
it
I'll start...
It definitely sees you.
I'll start...
As a lore mouse, can I communicate with the snake?
Do you have snake-wise?
No. But it does allow rudimentary communication as a lore mouse.
Okay, roll it. Roll it.
I'm gonna... As the snake sort of focuses on Randall, you know, mm-hmm. I'm gonna yell, like, from behind in, like, the best way I can for, like, snake-ness. Yeah. You know? Like, we have you surrounded! Surrender, scaly demon! let me see if I can, as a lore master mouse, how many points do I have in lore master again? Let me check.
Let's see if Elf can get good lore successes mouse. On parcel tongues.
I got one success.
Alright, well, the snake doesn't seem to falter as it starts to emerge from the hole.
Damn it.
Slowly, thankfully, but its gaze trained on Randall. and you can see from the...
You're talking extremely loud. Can you please be quiet?
Bear. I mean, I don't think I was that loud.
All right, from the size of the snake, you can tell that, you know, two snakes couldn't fit through at once.
Okay.
It's a small hole, but it's coming out.
Fucking change anything at all. Can you please stop talking?
That is an angry sister.
How about you fuck off, man?
Get out of here.
This is my hopes.
Why is she so mad?
I know, sir.
Says you're ruining the immersion.
Illusion. Oh my god.
All right.
You're ruining the immersion. Let me just.
We'll give you a minute to. We'll relocate. No problem.
Wow. If my sister did that
GM
to me.
Problems.
Yeah. Hashtag.
My sister. I would tell her to get the fuck out and shut up.
Hey man. All I have to say is my boyfriend is more tolerant than your sister. I am fucking loud all the time.
I got told to shut up the other day, but, I mean, Ragvasha was there, and I was actually yelling at Pat. So.
Oh, God. Okay. Another room, then. Hold on.
Captain Kirk came down, and he had to tell me.
What, is your sister in every single fucking room? Yeah.
Show us your house.
We're getting the house tour right now.
The tour of the ceiling. That is a wonderful... I like what you're doing with the vaulted ceiling.
I'm a fan of the... I'm a fan of the, what did you call it, like the what do you call that framing along the top of a...
I don't know.
Molding, the molding.
The molding.
Yeah.
GM problems.
Hashtag GM problems.
Hashtag GM problems.
Hashtag Vicky sister
problems. Yeah, it sounds more like hashtag sister problems, yeah.
Sorry about that. No worries. I open my mouth and she gets mad. Alright, so the snake emerges from the hole, and... Everyone gets to see it slowly coming out. It's pretty fucking big. Anyone who's seen a snake knows that this is a big snake.
I don't want to fight it. Anyway, communication.
Once I realize that I'm far enough out of the hole, that way everybody can kind of, you know, have a good, you know, strike at it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll turn to face it, basically. With my large sword in hand.
Randall's just staring down the snake.
Yeah.
Are you? Okay. All right.
Yeah, I will fight it.
You'll fight it. Conflict time.
Can we help?
Yes.
That's the goal.
During conflict, you split into teams, and you can use each other's dice rolls. Like, whoever's the highest, you can use to roll. Hold on.
Okay.
I will split with either Alern or Abernathy.
Yeah. You mostly want two people with good fight on different teams so they can use their fight dice.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. So.
So I will split with Elf, and then Tinkleton will split with Alern.
All right.
Yes. Alern would probably have been like yelling out to like Tinkleton the whole time and be like, after the first strike, if you get behind his head, it can't see you because it can only see in certain directions. I know this. I know this. I've seen enough snakes in the wilderness, and I've killed maybe one or two.
I've killed maybe one or two.
When they strike, they can't see behind them.
It's at this point where if I'm hearing them, like, we're fighting the snake now. If we weren't fighting the snake, Abernathy would be saying, like, how big were these snakes you killed? Like, you're such a liar.
Oh my god.
Look at it. Its eyes only point forward. Loud. It's a predator.
How is she still following you around? I don't understand. Your house does not look like a small place. Like, is she like, I want to be in this room. Get out. And you leave, go to another room. She comes to that room. She's like, now I'm here.
What is she trying to do that needs total quiet?
Yeah.
Anything?
Grab one of your knives. Sword.
Redner.
Come back.
If I was you, I'd be like, fuck off.
Anyway.
You're up, man.
Okay.
Now
I need to actually...
Yeah, don't worry about it.
trying to remember what to roll.
For conflict?
Yeah, I have. There you go. Okay. We need your starting disposition.
Well, I'm angry, right? So.
Yeah, you're angry.
So. I'm angry, and so is Alern, so both teams have anger.
So you get a minus one to that, but what you need to do is I need whoever's the highest to roll either fighter or hunter.
Fighter.
Ooh, mm-hmm. Hunter.
Whoever is the highest, just per team.
Fighter once. Or hunter? I don't have fighter. Either of those. So.
Okay. What's your fighter?
It's like your team that
five.
Has it.
Rack is
hunters at five. So.
Okay. Yeah.
Randall's on my team, so.
Not only so need one person per team to roll. Yeah.
Okay. So.
Okay.
Tinkle, and you can
So Tinkleton and Ellern need to figure out who has the highest roll out of
we,
the fighter.
We both have five. That's.
Okay, well, then you need to decide, okay, I guess.
Just roll five, yeah.
I don't care. Pig, you can roll it if you want. I don't give a shit.
All right, I'll roll it.
All right.
Three turns.
Me.
Yeah.
Let me get this.
And then how do we assist?
What? That didn't even work.
You have
macro.
Your macro is off.
You have a space at the roll.
You have a space, yeah. You need it to get rid of the space between slash and the wall.
I'll fix it.
Sibling aggro.
Hashtag fish yeah, sister.
There. Three successes.
Yeah. All right.
Shoot with bow.
So, both groups have successes, but.
Okay. Well, let me just.
Snake greater than mice equals DPK.
Okay. So
someone
you add.
Someone gonna die.
Yeah. You add those successes to either your total. Health or your nature. You don't need to roll health or nature. You just add
the
highest.
The total of the group or the total of the highest person in the group?
Highest person in the group.
Okay, so I have five, Rack.
Six. Okay.
Five what?
Health.
I have...
Then it's going to Tinkleton.
I have five will. Okay, yeah. Okay, so I only have four nature and four health, so add it to your health.
Okay, so we have seven for our team.
Seven, all right.
Nine for our team.
All right, sweet. Nine. The snake is 10.
The fidgety guy and the actual like recruit are like at the top right now.
I was gonna say any team that has Abernathy in it, like.
Okay, what is Randall's and Abernathy's?
Seven.
Okay.
Any team that has Abernathy in it.
We have this. Predators always have eyes that face forward. Listen to Aller and he knows his shit.
My god.
It's true, though. It's true. Evolutionary facts, yo.
Evolutionary facts.
Does that make me a predator? I have eyes that face forward.
Yeah, actually.
Yep. Humans
nice.
Are predators.
Yep. Humans are predators, actually.
Depth perception. Alright, now you need to come up with a conflict goal. It could be like, kill the snake, drive it away.
Hit its eyes.
Do that.
Hit its eyes.
what's our conflict goal, Randall?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can kill it. You can, make it flee.
If I can handle a weasel, I can handle a snake.
Right? I mean, my conflict goal is live, but that's...
that's a given.
Yeah.
Hey, you
I guess...
Hit it in the eyes?
I guess
get... we kill it.
Okay, I'll kill it, yeah.
It's up to you, though.
I'm basically like a spectator in the fight, you know. I'm helping you out, but only by like poking
Wait,
in sometimes
is
with a spear.
Is this
the
conflict
know?
Goal during the whole fight, or the conflict goal for the attack we're doing?
The whole fight.
Get rain.
Oh yeah, kill it. Kill the shit out of it.
Get reins on it and ride it like a mount.
It's not an insect.
Kill it.
I'm already gonna say no. Okay.
I don't have my insect mount with me.
What's Randall's and Abernathy's goals?
Kill it.
Kill it.
Okay.
Like we're all on kill it.
Oh my god! Kill You're gonna murder this snake.
Going for it.
It can't,
kill
it,
this bitch today.
It can't hurt us if we kill it, right?
I'm gonna skin this thing and make armor.
Its corpse could fall on you. That'd probably be pretty heavy.
That's why I have a bow. I keep my distance.
Oh my god.
Anyway, let Bear continue, guys.
All right. And the second page of your sheet.
Mm-hmm.
There should be disposition and then actions descriptions.
Yep.
Okay. So those are the four you can do. Normally attack and defend is the most basic one.
Attack, defend,
what you
feint,
do,
and maneuver.
Yes. What you do in a conflict is each team secretly decides three actions in a row what they're going to do. You know, attack, defend, blah, blah, blah. Any combination.
Okay.
Secretly. And then after that's all decided, everyone sort of... It all resolves at once. So you can defend against an attack, or feint relies on what the other person is doing.
Okay.
Like, you can feint against an attack, it does this. If feint against a feint, you make a test. It's feint is complicated. Don't
let's just go attack, defend, and like
yeah,
like,
go with attack, defend. It's the easiest.
So we need to.
I want to attack.
So we need for three actions to do something as our group, right? So we have to choose like attack, defend, or like defend, attack, defend, or stuff like that.
Yeah.
Okay. So what do you reckon, Rack? Because it's each team, right?
Each team, yeah.
So what do you reckon, Rack?
And your weapons.
You have the focus of the snake, as far as I'm aware. So I feel like we should turtle. Defend. We should turtle, yeah. So we could just like triple defend while they triple attack, and then.
Yeah, I was thinking we triple attack, right, Pig?
And then
we got fucking nine on that, so.
I think what I just said there, attack, maneuver, attack. I think we need
the
to get behind it.
Maneuver. Oh, okay.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Like run. Trying to get, like, around it.
Okay, so let's do that. Me and Rack will defend and, like, taunt.
While it's focused there, we're already, like, hitting it from the side, and then we're going to kind of run around behind.
Okay.
And then hit it again.
Yeah.
And hit it again.
And, your weapons add certain...
Add certain bonuses, yeah.
Add certain bonuses, yeah.
I'll be using my sword.
Albert.
Okay.
Plus one dice to
one. Yeah. Oh, plus two maneuver. Awesome. Plus one attack. Yes!
Plus one maneuver.
That's good.
That'd be awesomeness. Right.
Plus one D to maneuver. What's plus one S?
That's one success, right?
Oh, okay.
Or no,
that's
yeah.
Automatic success.
Because I'm using axe. I'm using axe part of
it. Oh, sweet. I can send messages to myself so I keep track of this. All right. So, let's do the first round. Let's go left to right. Rack and Abernethy's. Group, what are you doing? Defending?
We're defending. So roll our fight dice again, and then defend.
Defend is
or nature.
Yeah. There you go. Skills by conflict. Defend. You roll nature. Oh, sorry, lore or nature.
Lore or fight nature.
Animal. Fight animal. Yep. Skills by conflict. Bottom
chart.
Left.
Oh, I see. Okay. So nature, I have a 4, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
What about
so
you?
You roll that?
What about you, Rack?
I also have a 4.
Okay, so I'll roll this time.
Do we get plus one to that from?
You can
helping or no?
You can help. Yeah, you get a plus one.
Okay.
So 5. Yep.
So rolling 5, we get 3 successes on defend.
3 successes. Okay, you do that. Margin of success disposition. No, you cannot have higher. It does. Word vomit. Defending increases your disposition.
Okay.
And you can't have higher than max, so you're good there.
Okay.
And, right, the snake is... Okay, what's Pig and Tinkle... What is Pig and Tinkleton doing?
Attacking, maneuvering, and attacking again.
Alright.
What do we roll?
Fighter, hunter.
Fighter or hunter.
Mm-hmm.
Either one.
Fighter or hunter, either one, yeah.
Yeah, you're the first attack. Go!
Yeah, your roll this time.
3 successes.
Okay.
Without a help, right?
Yep. Let me just put this down.
Oh, was I supposed to also roll a help? Because I have to add one more dice to that then.
Oh, yeah.
That's why you split into teams, so you can help each other.
Yeah. Alright, so 4 successes.
Alright.
You're also attacking with the halberd, right?
Yep, so I get one
That's
automatic
six.
Success.
6.
What, automatic? My god.
So 4
well,
or 5.
It's
5.
S, right?
Six.
Yeah. One S.
Yeah, plus one S.
At success.
Success, yeah.
So 5 successes.
Yeah.
5?
Yeah. Screw your disposition, snake.
Oh my god, that snake.
He's going in!
Dude, Tinkleton came to fight.
Guys, mouse halberds are, like, really good against snakes. I don't know if you knew this, but I've just discovered recently.
just like... 30 seconds ago.
Oh my god. Alright.
I may not have a cloak, but I got a halberd, bitch.
You guys have got like one success, we're gonna lower it by 4 disposition.
Oh my god. Okay.
I don't fully mm-hmm. understand the like what we're doing other than
it's it takes a bit to get used to.
It's basically you have a margin of success. It's a opposed roll.
Yeah.
If we get mm-hmm. 5 successes, it gets 2. We have a margin of success of 3.
Okay, but then like are we attacking its health or are we attacking its
you attack its disposition?
Disposition.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
And then after that it goes to health after disposition or something like that?
Once your disposition is drained, we enter a compromise and like you won, but you got to figure out if you lost a lot of health, you'll actually suffer as well.
Yeah, it's like a matter of narrative after that.
Yeah, it is. It is.
Cool. Okay. All right. I just wanted to like understand a little better.
It has to get enough margin of success to beat our disposition elf since we're defending.
Yeah.
Yep. Da-da-da. It's going to attack Randall and it fucking fails absolutely horribly. You guys are fine.
Because oh,
Randall, it comes to attack. It like comes to attack him, and he just like chops at one of the fangs. It's like it pulls back.
Oh, God. I was the grain peddler, but he died.
Oh,
I told you he was gonna die.
That's fine.
I'm okay with it.
All right, so let's go to the second action. What are y'all doing for your second action?
I'm moving.
We're already at max, so we should.
Oh, we should attack.
Yeah. So we'll attack, and that's up to you, I think, because that's fight or hunter. So
mm-hmm. yeah,
add a help from me. I'm basically going like, yeah, fuck you.
What
snake.
The hell? Okay, two.
two.
Seven dice, 2 successes.
Do you want to go this time, or should I?
Yeah, I'm maneuvering. Okay.
Yeah, because
I'm probably not getting any help from you because you're just standing there like swinging your halberd.
Well, I mean, the halberd also gives +1 maneuver.
2.
2 successes?
2.
Ooh, that was a less successful turn.
That was sucked. Let's suck.
Still, margin of success.
Let's suck's revenge.
Yeah.
Snake eats you.
Margin of success eats you.
Snake eats you, you're dead.
It's gonna defend. I'm not used to GM rolling. I keep having to retype it.
Okay, soon you'll get so used to GM rolling that you'll GM roll.
Yeah, you'll GM roll when you don't want to, yeah.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's the
one
second again.
Why Duncan now has, like, 8 new macros.
Yeah.
Alright. Well, the snake got really terrible. They got shit success when defending.
Oh, so, man.
Alright, let's see.
Shitter than 2?
It got 1 success.
that means it takes a -1 D on its next action, then.
It does.
Maneuver.
It does. Okay.
I've impeded its process!
Okay, let me just write that down. -1 die.
Yeah, I could read.
Sorry about that.
I say we're gonna have to attack again, then, Elf.
I think you're right, yeah.
Alright, next round. Let's do this.
If it defended, then we'll have to...
Hit it again, Rack.
Pig, we should attack.
Yep.
There we go.
That's our next thing.
My god.
Should I do it because I have an automatic success?
Sure.
Alright.
Yeah, because you get the halberd success.
And I'm rolling 6 dice because you're helping me, right?
Yeah.
And I haven't even...
Around. Help it!
I haven't even rolled for the
5 successes again.
In the combat.
I'm just waiting till I can get another maneuver and bow this guy right in the face for like fucking 8 successes.
Well, judging that... You did 8, and it's at 5, and it's attacking Randall. It's... Oh, no, you... Oh, it's done. It is so done.
We just, like, obliterated the snake.
You know what? It did nothing to you. You obliterate that snake.
All the disadvantages in the world.
It's,
guys, Elf, I told you, Tinkleton the Obliterator.
No, it's cool, because, like, the snake... Okay, does anybody mind if I, like, take a little narrative into our own
hands
here?
Yeah, you know what?
Here?
You go right ahead.
If you guys
you
don't mind.
You were the GM here. Yeah.
I mean the way that I see this going down is like the snake comes out of the hole, you know, and mm-hmm. me and Allern are on either side of the hole, and the snake is like focused on Randall, and Tinkleton of course is like getting his halberd ready in the back, and as the snake strikes down at Randall for that first attack, Randall like deflects it, and Tinkleton and me and Allern just start like poking it with whatever we've got. Allern's just like firing arrows. I'm like. attacking it with the spear and, like, the hard scales, and Tinkleton's running in and just going, like, ah, right in its face, like, with a halberd.
Ellern is kind of more towards, like, Tinkleton, and he's like, strike at the back of its head, quickly, on the left side, the left side!
Yeah.
And he's, like, Ellern's firing like arrows in the meantime.
I mean, honestly, like, Abernathy's doing almost nothing to, like, help. He's kind of, like, standing off to the side going, like, yeah!
It's a wild animal. It's kind of my forte of killing.
Oh no, I'm the only red mouse. Why is this happening?
No, you kill it. Look at that.
Look, there's a sword through the top of its head. But, yeah, so basically, like, yeah.
You bring your halberd just
I didn't see the sword on the top of the head. I just saw it.
You just grate the eyeball. You just,
I've got a picture for that.
Yeah, you just halberd the shit out of
it. Halberd the shit out of it. It thrashes several times, and it goes still, and it's...
Oh, God! Like, can you imagine giant snake thrashing? I mean, I'm just saying, like, if you hit and it's huge, like, whoosh, flicking tail around everywhere,
yeah,
like...
Yeah, you have... Abernathy has to duck as this huge thing flying over his head.
I just see it as that one success on the maneuver was, like, me running past the snake, and it just catches, like, a glimpse of me out of the side of its eye, and it's like... Do I turn to hit him? And that's when Tinkleton's
and
like,
the
oh! <It's> just...
I imagine a slow-mo where it just turns its head and then the halberd just...
Like, right in the eye.
I mean, Randall takes all the hate, but, like, we get it down. flawless victory.
The
snake is most definitely dead.
All right, Tinkleton's gonna walk up and put his hand on it and go, do you guys think we can get any gold for this?
Do we have gold in Mouseland? I don't
know. Yeah, like, what is the type of money?
Currency. Oh my god.
Great.
We'll use gold for now because I don't want to look it up. But...
Yeah.
Oh.
Mouse tokens.
I think this would fare a good amount, don't you think? Waste not, whatnot.
Materials.
That wasn't really our mission.
But moving it somewhere is the issue.
We have a grain cart.
Well, we're not far out from Elmos. We're not far out from Elmos, right? Like,
we can bring some guards.
Probably. But anyway, Abernathy is going to seeing the snake is dead. He's going to say, is that where the grain merchant ended up?
Only one way to figure it out. Takes out the halberd to go start cutting the snake open.
Oh no.
Oh, no.
Randall just kind of stares at the hole, like, waiting for the next challenge, in case there's another one coming.
Randall hears no movement from the snake hole. And, Tinkleton finds...
Oh, no.
Tinkleton finds the little grain peddler.
Aww.
Yeah.
I think I found him.
I'm gonna turn to Randall and be like, is that the guy?
I like...
His little straw hat.
Look over the body. I believe this is who we're looking for.
Ellern's like, I said earlier that this was not a safe place to be. As we can see, he's dead. I told you all, this is why we needed to hurry earlier, but he's dead.
I just realized that Ellern is Jeff Goldblum, the mouse.
Pretty much.
It's
find a way.
My goal was also accomplished. I got to kill something.
Randall's gonna start, you know, walking into the snake den.
All right.
Do we have any source of light? Because that's a snake hole.
Your mousy eyes can discern.
Yeah,
most
well,
of
mouse.
It.
We're a mouse underground.
Oh yeah, I forgot.
I'll speak back to the group. Considering we're this close to my hometown, it would be best if we take care of this full infestation before anything else should happen. We need to venture further in to find out if there's anything else that may cause problems for peddlers in the area.
You want me to take a look down there, boss?
Yes, you come with me, Ellern, Tinkleton. You take up the rear just in case one comes home.
You can see Tinkleton's eyes, like, glittering, like, we get to kill some more things, more fighting!
He's like, I'm gonna stay at the back, because I don't want to see what else is down here.
We're still going in the hole.
So I'm gonna roll Scout, I guess, down into the hole?
All right.
Just to take a look around.
Just to see how many there are in.
Yeah, two successes for Scout in the hole.
All right. From what you can discern, there only was a single snake living in the hole, and okay. You obviously took care of it. Though, as both of you, you and Randall, I'm assuming, mm-hmm. descend further downwards, you end up in a little, a little room, a little opening, and there's a small clutch of eggs there. But the rest of it seems empty.
Kill the eggs, fuck them things.
So we're standing, like, in front of this clutch of snake eggs. Mm-hmm. You know, considering what we have to do here, I'm going to turn to Randall and sort of look for his, you know, say-so first, before I offer my own advice. After all, he's the patrol leader.
And, you think you can sell those?
You know, his wisdom is best. Tinkleton is a fucking mercenary, man.
Randall,
in huge amounts of debt, dude.
From your predator-wise, you can tell that the snake was more likely defending its nest rather than, you know, going after you out of any other way. Any other reason, though, it was obviously the patch, the root around where this grain peddler was taken was its newly designated hunting route, so it's probably best that you took it out.
Okay. If there are eggs,
mm-hmm.
can I roll predator-wise to see, how long it takes for eggs to hatch, how long these may have been sitting here.
Okay. Roll.
I'm not sure if I could
decide. We could tame tiny snakes and have a whole city of snake mounts.
No.
but they might eat more of the grain peddlers.
They get
peddlers,
bigger.
Okay?
They get much bigger.
If they eat more of the grain peddlers, then that would be bad for us.
Well, why don't we just leave the eggs alone and cave the tunnel in?
Because
my God.
If snakes can dig, how does the tunnel get there in the first place?
So there are
I have a halberd.
There are approximately 10 eggs, and you can tell that they're, from, obviously, your role, you can tell that these snakes, this specific kind, their eggs, they usually lay them and they hatch after about 2-ish months, so they look about halfway. If you leave them, they'll probably die anyway.
Let's not leave them.
Yeah, because they'll be, like, cold or whatever, right?
Yeah, cold or whatever.
Probably is something I don't care about.
Probably, but you're not entirely sure.
I mean,
birds and snakes, know, different things.
Call me old-fashioned, but I can't really condone smashing helpless eggs.
Learn, Abernathy, I need you to go back up. I need you to watch the entrance of the tunnel. Tinkleton and I will take care of this. Shout down if you see any incoming predators.
Okay. I'll be just up there.
Abernathy's gonna disagreeably wander back to the front of the tunnel. Not super happy with the course of action. He's fine to let them die, but he's not fine with killing them, you know?
Part of my beliefs, man. Action of one mouse, save all mice kind! Okay, so...
Kill the babies. So,
obviously,
kill the babies.
Tinkleton and I'll just, you know, start smashing eggs and, you know, anything that may have gestated inside.
All right, Tinkleton's gonna like laugh while he's doing this the whole time, like he's having
psycho.
The ball.
Oh God, it just doesn't register to him that these are creatures living. Okay.
Hey man, he's seen the Weasel Wars. He knows what happens when you let things slide.
Like snakes.
Literally.
like snakes. One grain peddler's enough to sway his actions.
One grain peddler. Well, you
one grain peddler who was gonna betray like everything.
But if it had been a mouse that wasn't betraying people.
Elf is stuck smiling forever.
I know.
Not on my screen.
Oh yeah, like, Elf is smiling forever on that. That's
he's
okay.
Like
what if Elf, what if it was your parents? Your little mousy parents, huh? What if they got eaten?
Look, I'm just saying. You know, the eggs will die on their own.
Found the dude.
Probably.
We found the grain cart. Why do I care about anything else?
Fair enough.
Well, Randall and Tinkleton, they managed to smash all of the eggs without incident.
Fucking Tinkleton.
So I'll wipe off the blade on the... like a root or something, and
Yeah, you find one. It's there.
Sheath it and start moving back up the hole.
All right. Abernathy and Allern, as they're waiting outside, see or hear no other predators approaching and no travelers. It's about about evening since you've done your work, and it seems like many mice are either close to their towns or have turned in for the night.
Anybody think we can start chopping the snake in like pieces and move it?
Abernathy looking a little bit more energetic as the evening wears on, the guy liking the nighttime, is going to shake his head at Tinkleton and be like, you killed the snake. We killed the snake in self-defense. Then you killed the eggs when you didn't have to, and now you want to desecrate the corpse?
Abernathy, I never told you that I destroyed the eggs. I merely took care of the problem.
I'm not an idiot, Randall. You sent me and Allern away.
Well, Abernathy, it's not like the snake is using his body anymore.
All I want to know is that are we setting up camp here, or are we going back to town?
Randall, you're the boss. Oh, okay.
He's one moment.
Yeah. It's cool. I have had my one moments.
Your sister just like follows you around and harasses you.
Yeah, it was to the point at some point where I would turn my TV volume above 3 and I would get yelled at. Like, it's...
What the fuck?
I don't know.
Is your sister bipolar?
No, just angry.
Just a bitch.
just a bitch.
Is she, hold on, is she your older sister?
No.
Really?
I'm just a doormat, yeah.
The younger ones are always the spoiled ones.
What, bitch? Quick car!
Okay. Sorry about that.
Yeah, you're all good.
Alright.
What was said after I said that?
Are we making camp here?
Are we setting up camp here, or are we going back to town?
Randall is the advisor,
How long until we hit Elmos again?
It's just gonna start evening. Like, evening is just starting, so you can hit Elmos.
By the time it's night.
Yeah, by sundown.
And then we'll head there.
Yeah, okay.
We'll leave the snake body here.
I'm going to at least take a fang.
You're going to pry a snake fang out.
You take a snake fang. It's big.
I want a trophy.
It's pretty fucking big, yeah. It's like this fucking big. It's like a sword.
You're a mouse. There's your snake fang.
Like, mice can only carry so much. You know that.
They can.
Right?
Seriously though, a snake fang, like, you're looking at like almost half as tall as you. That's at least, maybe even taller.
That's all good.
Like,
tall.
Like, snake fang could be like great sword territory for a mouse.
That's fine.
Okay.
That's a lot of snake fang.
All I'm saying is, like, while you're pulling it out, you like deserve to get venomed or something, like, by accident.
I never said the snake had venom. He's like probably a garden snake or something like that to us.
No, man, it's a cobra. King cobra.
I didn't say anything.
It's a king cobra.
A
you're
cobra.
Dead now.
We just took on a cobra that easy. I don't think it was a cobra.
No.
Anyway.
I mean, I could say it's a big snake, but you're mice, so it's just...
Tinkleton, you know, I could take that tooth and I could maybe make, like, an axe or something out of it. You know, I could... I don't know, maybe I could do something like that.
Like a pick.
Survival so good.
Snake pick.
But jury rig emergency tools. I made an axe!
Oh, I can make a snake
scythe.
So, I guess you return to the road.
Yeah.
Not sure if you're heading to Elmos yet.
Well, yeah,
you know,
that's
the car's
what,
still
yeah.
there.
That's what we'll be doing.
That's the plan. We'll take the cart to Elmos.
All right, so.
With the snake thing on it.
With the snake on it. All right.
I'm not putting the snake fang on the grain.
Yeah.
Carry the snake fang.
Just, right. You know, move the grain away, put the snake fang on top.
No. You can carry the snake fang.
You make it back to Elmos, and it's not my turn to test you anymore. Player's turn.
Okay.
You tell me what you want to do.
All right.
Well, you get one roll each.
Sell the fence.
First of all, find us lodging either at my house
Okay, you can do so.
Or whatever else.
Yeah, you don't need to roll for that. You're fine.
I didn't think so.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll open it to everybody else before I do my thing.
Okay. Well, let's see. What can I do? We're in Elmos, so that's like not really anywhere that I really want to be.
Yep, I'll just bring up the description of
that.
But
what I am going to do is, because I'm nocturnal, I'm going to dick around during the night and like scout about the area and just make sure that there's nothing else that could be dangerous sort of in the near locations. You know, like if there's a snake den like that close, that's that's like not really that great. So maybe they've been lax on their patrols or like their security and stuff. And during the night, like Abernathy's all about like wachaha doing stuff, you know. So he'll be like scouting around Elmos basically, and making sure that everything is all cool elsewise. So two successes right. for that.
Well, you find no more snake holes, thankfully, but you've heard a couple. But you have some signs that you found of some bird attacks. You can't identify which bird, but you know it's a bird of prey, obviously. There have been a couple mice missing in Elmos that you didn't check up on while you were going after this grain peddler.
Okey-dokey.
It's not an eagle of some sort, but it's still something that you probably need to look into later on.
It's a bird. It's a big bird.
It's a bird. It's a bird.
It's bird. A plane. Okay. Anybody else? What other people are gonna do during the night here?
Go ahead, Ellen.
Like, sleep?
Weather watch sleep!
If you want, you can make a roll to get rid of your angry condition as well.
Okay. Yeah. What do I roll for that?
I just had the,
Am I allowed to do that too, or did I my scout roll not?
Your scout roll did that, but you didn't know, so I'll let you roll again.
No, it's fine.
I'll go easy on you.
It's
okay.
Fine.
All right.
I'll just be angry the rest of the time.
Just angry all the time.
Well, it makes sense that he's angry because like Randall fucking smashing eggs and stuff. And just, like, all right,
you need to roll. Roll your will, and you need at least two successes.
Okay. I like that. We'll roll this. I think I'm good.
You're good. You are no longer angry. Once you hit Elmos, you find a nice way to relax and kind of take your mind off of all of the crap that's happened with the snake and trying to track it down and getting angry at Abernathy.
Hot tub time, bitches!
I'm gonna just take some of this grain because the guy's dead and that means nobody owns the cart or the grain, so I just take a couple. Not all of it, like maybe a couple, I'll just stick in my bag.
I'm gonna try and find a merchant to sell the fang. But I also want to talk to the merchant.
So you're...
Alright.
So you're gonna roll circles?
Circles, yeah. I was tied between circles and resources. Give me circles.
I have zero in circles.
I have six in circles.
You've at least one. Give me one die for circles, unless you don't want to... Unless you want to do something else, but...
Dear Christ.
One success?
Yeah.
You find a merchant, and you drop this snake fang onto his little desk.
I talk to the merchant, and I go, I have a proposition for you.
Hey, he's looking at this fang like, oh, God.
He looks at you. He doesn't see the cloak, and he's like, how did... What?
Me and my band just killed the snake. This is the
band?
Thing from that snake. Well, we're in a guard patrol.
What
first day, it was awesome.
What do you want me to do with this? What?
Use this? You're gonna buy it.
Well, let me talk.
What can I use this
There's
for?
There's also the giant snake body. I can tell you where it is. And you can use its skin for whatever you like. And also you can use the fang for whatever you like.
this little Elmos merchant is like, I will never need any of that stuff.
I know. It's like little brown mouse and like a blue vest and a hat. He's like, what do you want me to do with this? It's a snake. I don't deal in snake things.
I sell grain.
He's like, Kaiser. I weave cloth. I don't.
I weave cloth. What do you want?
Imagine.
What
you... Imagine what you can what do with you? The skin of a snake.
I am a basket weaver. I am not a hunter.
I sell moss.
Fucking like, Tinkleton.
I'm guessing I'm not getting like... anywhere with this guy.
No, this is a okay. This is a town full of carpenters and farmers.
Carpenters.
This guy doesn't know what you want to do. He can obviously he can direct you to a town that would probably want the snake hide, but he has absolutely nothing he can do with it.
Let's talk to the guy and see where I can find a merchant that will take a snake and the snake remains.
Oh my god.
We're not taking a snake that far. We can't even drag
no,
the
no,
snake.
No, no, no. I'm going to tell him where it is.
Oh. Yes, because well, it'll know, still be there.
You know, Lockhaven will always have artisans that could make use of any, you know, animal supplies or
all right,
hides
so I'm waiting
to make
we go to Lockhaven. I'm going to carry the okay. thing with me.
All right.
Good day, gentlemen.
Going to be known as Tinkleton Snake Fang.
Tinkleton Snake Fang.
Snake you know, if I could make this into a scythe, I would be so happy.
It's possible.
I might do that. Snake I might fang. Just sell the body and just, you know, keep the fang to make a scythe.
Alright, so, anybody else?
I will roll circles to find mm-hmm. another grain peddler in the area. Or okay. someone who could make use of the grain and grain cart.
Mm. Oh yeah, you find someone really easily. This is a farm town, and so one of the oh, yeah, little farmers there. Yeah.
I didn't even so add my extra die.
You ain't even need that. You know, a friend of a friend of mine. They take it off your hands really easily. They'll find use for it. They have some roots going back between Barkstone and Max, so it won't go unused, unwanted.
Okay, so I'll basically leave the cart with them mm-hmm. and consider my duty to the mouse kind done.
All right.
Mousedom.
All of mousedom.
All of mousedom. Where is... Okay.
And then do the lodging thing before we leave for the morning.
Well, yeah, you find lodging. You don't ever need to roll for that in your hometown. You're good.
All right. Also, we're mouse guard. We just be like, guys, we're mouse guard. And people will be like, sure, buddy.
Most people, some people are like, yeah, fuck the mouse guard.
Yeah,
they're all Skeletor.
Yeah, I never needed those. Where were they last winter when I found that snake?
When I found that snake.
All right. No. That's my snake.
Oh my god. Okay, yeah. There we go. I just wanted to find it. There we go. And yeah, there's your mission. Let's go through the. You'll
are
get rewards.
Back to Lockhaven now, or?
Yeah, yeah. You
make our way back to Lockhaven.
Mm-hmm.
I have Fine to return merchant. this letter, this detailed
oh, right.
map.
Yeah, the map. The map of which I have no idea. It exists because I was sleeping at the time.
Alern yeah. and I are basically the only ones that have seen.
Yeah, like even Abernathy shouldn't be able to have a map this detailed unless. He actually really needed it.
I do so have Guard's Honor, though.
Guard's Honor, true. Alright. So, you make your way back to Lockhaven, thankfully.
I would have a map like this.
I may be a lazy layabout, but I am actually quite guardy.
Guardy.
The sleep guard. Mm.
The bubble has an eye.
You make your way back to Lockhaven rather snake-free, thankfully.
Yay!
Yay! No more peddlers going missing, you know. And the guard welcomes you back with open arms, and you're pretty much almost immediately directed back to Gwendolyn, cool. to report your mission status.
I just tag along as necessary mm-hmm. until I'm dismissed, you know, mission and so forth.
Yeah.
I think we had a success, so I'm feeling pretty chuffed. Other than the fact that the merchant died, but that was, like, unforeseeably not our fault.
Yeah.
So, I'm not really concerned.
Nothing we could have done about that.
I show Gwendolyn the snake thing.
She blinks. I got a souvenir. So we, I'm assuming you met some sort of snake on the way.
We have dispatched of a snake that had attacked a grain peddler and actually eaten him alive.
Okay. So you managed to find him in the end. Where was he along these lines? She kind of spreads open the map again and takes a look.
Me having written down the coordinates to remember where the snake was. Point.
he'll point to basically the approximate area. Nicholson could probably narrow it down a little more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he'll point to the
exactly.
The approximate place and say it was just outside of my hometown of Elmos, but we've taken care of any threats that may arise from this.
Okay, and there were no more in the area?
Not that we could discern. However, there was a nest of approximately 10 eggs.
And they were taken care of in whatever way you saw appropriate?
That was fun.
They were taken care of. Grumble, grumble.
They were dispatched with haste.
Good. It was unfortunate that the grain peddler perished along the way, but I assume you got what else was needed, Randall?
That is correct, and I'll pull out the little slip of paper and kind of like, not allowing it to be noticed very easily, just kind of like real quick and then slide it across the table a little bit towards her.
Mm-hmm. Okay. She takes it and spreads it open. Her little mousy eyes go wide as she examines it. This is slightly worse than I expected.
It's found in the grain cart amongst the grain. After we had put the cart back upright and started to put the grain in, it had slipped out.
Okay.
Tinkleton kind of laughs at the we.
I'm gonna soil my hands, bro.
All right. Well, your next mission is to. I'll have you investigate either Barkstone or Root Wallow regarding this. Which direction was he headed in?
I think he was going back towards Barkstone.
Okay. Rest for now, but I'll send you over to Barkstone to investigate this later, because obviously he was bringing this information to someone. We just need to find out who. All right.
Flourish of the cape.
The old flourish, yeah.
As you wish, and he'll bow and turn. All right, good recruits.
Very good work. Especially the tender paw. I'm sure he proved himself. She eyes the fang.
Oh, yeah, proved himself. Oh, for sure.
I had a great time.
Someday he may make a fine patrol leader. But until then, I'll keep an eye on him.
Indeed. Rest well, patrol. You have much work to do in the morning.
Abernathy goes to his lodgings, sleeps like a rock.
Sleeps like, until the evening, I suppose.
Yep. Yeah.
Tinkleton goes to find a merchant. Roll it again.
You find one. No, it's fine. You don't need one.
It's Lockhaven. There's gonna be.
It's
a merchant.
Lockhaven. There's at least one. Yeah, you managed to find someone who deals in, you know, I'd say leather working, but they're mice. So.
Snakes, like a person who can do
people
shit
who
with
are
snake
skilled
bodies.
In the crafting of certain items involving skins.
The crafting of stuff.
Yeah.
All right. So
you
I
managed
put
to find the proper tradesman.
Put the snake fang on the table and go, hello there, I have a proposition for you.
Hello, Tinkleton. What is this proposition? I see you've brought something rather interesting.
Do we all carry maps, or, like, would I have a map in my possession?
Do you have any skills related to such?
No.
Okay. No, you wouldn't have a map on you, but I'm sure someone around Lockhaven does, like, even in the vicinity.
If you need to, like, show off where, sort of thing.
Yeah. you'll be able to show where someone has a map. I mean,
all of us getting interrupted today.
Yay.
It's okay.
All we need to know is that Phoenix is no cartographer.
Phoenix's mom in the camera.
Captain Kirk. He's not home yet.
He's not home.
Alrighty then. So yeah, I'm gonna try and find somebody with a map. Be like, one second. Well, first I'll ask him if he has a map.
He rummages through his shelves. I'm just gonna roll D100 because I can. Yeah, okay, he manages to pull out a spare map and he lays it on the table.
As you can see, I have killed a snake. And it was a very large, large snake.
Okay.
So, what I want to know is, would you want to go get it and use its hide?
Well, it would certainly be useful. Anything we can take from it will help the guard. The crafting of supplies and other such things.
Okay. Do I get any gold out of it if I tell you?
He gives you... He narrows his eyes. You know the mouse guard runs off of donations and such, right?
Oh, this guy's part of the mouse guard?
Yeah, Lockhaven.
All of Lockhaven is.
Yeah, Lockhaven is like the mouse.
Lockhaven.
I'm just gonna tell him where it is then.
It's just Mouse Guard Central, man.
Yeah. Would you be able to make a weapon out of this thing?
I don't know if I can make a weapon, but I could certainly find someone who can craft something of use from it. Water horn.
Really big water horn.
Really big water horn.
Just give him the fang too. I'm not making anything off of this.
Alright. Hey, to be fair, you're not making anything off of this, but all your shit you get for free.
Phoenix's cat just like bounded across the background.
That's great. Okay, he takes the thing. And he sets it aside, so he can work on that and goes, thank you, I'll see if we can send out some mice to go get what we can off of the snake corpse, and if there's anything we can fashion for you from it, I'm sure we'll let you know.
Good to know.
Mm-hmm.
Singleton kind of leaves, like, God damn, I'm never going to finish off this debt.
God damn it. Can I, for the evening, make a weather check or whatever?
Go ahead.
Just because I want to roll it.
Yeah, you know what? You need at least 6 successes.
Yeah, I only have 1.
Oh, that's okay. All right, are you checking the weather, or are you just trying to...
I guess I'm checking the weather.
All right. It's dark.
It's dim.
I'm kidding.
I have Nightwise as well, if that helps. So.
Nightwise, man, okay.
If it's dark weather out, then shouldn't some dark elementals be spawning? We can get some clusters from those.
Can I get anything from dark elementals?
Dark elementals.
Dark crystals and dark clusters, bro.
You motherfuckers.
Oh my god. You can tell that the weather will be clear for at least tomorrow, but you're hoping several days to come. Mm. Winter isn't coming anytime soon, and there's no clouds
until
in the sky.
Until the morning, Abernathy's just gonna do his thing, getting prepared to like head back out towards Barkstone because of the whole new task thing.
Yeah. Alright.
Yeah, Singleton's gonna get ready to go beforehand, go to bed, very, very sad.
My god. Alright, and what are the other two doing for the night?
Basically, I'll acquire provisions again, and basically set up for the next mission. Lay out a map and whatnot. Basically, chart a course.
All right. Yeah, you do so with no issue at all. I mean, if you can't seem to do it yourself, there's always someone to help you. You have a ton of resources on your own, and with luck, and it's only amplified
Just like anything you want, you got it.
Going almost to Elmos, anything. Buying a right. place to retire. You'll never see Randall again.
Randall just rides off into the sunset.
Rides off into the sunset, yes.
Mission's done, retiring.
Hey Randall, you feel like paying off some debts?
You're a funny guy.
I've sold many weasel pelts to get this far in life.
Weasel pelts.
Weasel pelts.
It sort of hurts me that we're like that. That is like a sentient being in this universe that you're pelting.
I'm sorry, I didn't realize we pelted trees.
Pelted trees. You guys are horrible.
Some people wear human skin. I mean, some old tribes.
I wear human skin.
I wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah, neither would I.
I wouldn't really.
Anyway.
That's the end of your little mission.
What about Alan?
What's Alan doing?
Probably just like, I don't know, replenishing what's left of his provisions and then finding a nice spot to sleep just outside the town.
Lovely.
He's not like staying in towns.
Yeah.
He's a survivalist.
People might find
live
him.
Live off the land. People.
Since you're familiar with
Lockhaven.
Within
a safe distance of just outside the town.
All right. Since Lockhaven is the hub for all the Mosgard, you do have, I guess, a small tent set up just outside where people look at you funny, but they don't object.
It's like, whatever, man. If you want to be weird, that's fine. I don't care.
Yeah, you're like that weird guy who goes out in the woods and survives on his... You're like Bear Grylls, but without the media attention.
I don't know. I have six in circles, so...
So he's like Bear Grylls.
Okay, everyone knows you.
They all know him, and he lives in the woods.
You know the guy who lives out in the woods?
Yeah, he's so weird, right? Yeah, man, it's weird.
But he's such a nice guy, though.
And did you say that's the finale? That's the end of our little mission?
Yep, that's the wrap-up.
That's awesome.
While it is a one-shot, I want to go through the rewards, and this is just, like, earning points and stuff.
Lovely.
I find a ladybug.
Right,
as a...
earning fate points. And this is all decided as a group. Mm-hmm. Who do you think acted on their belief?
On their belief? Well,
on their belief,
I don't think
yeah.
it was me. I didn't really have a situation where which I could do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I wasn't really protecting those I loved. So it wasn't me.
You were all gung-ho at that mouse.
I was gung-ho on killing shit. I think... Randall, what's your belief?
My belief is that the action of one mouse can save all mice. To sacrifice oneself can save the world. Or the whole of the mouse kind.
It's probably Randall, I guess.
Well, hold on. What was Allern's?
Survival is like pretty much a way of life, and living off the land is pretty much his belief. So, no, he didn't.
No. So, yeah, it was Randall.
I think Randall probably.
Okay, Randall, you get a fate point.
By the way, Elf, Subway.
Yeah, I know. I can hear it.
Subway.
Shut up. I want Subway now.
No, because he can't leave his apartment to get Subway.
Okay, what else?
Let's see. If your character's actions worked towards your goal, but you did not accomplish it, you earn one fate point.
Okay, but we did accomplish it, so I think...
Mm-hmm. Maybe. Depending on what your goal was, everybody
Depending
was.
On what your goal for the mission was.
Oh, my goal for the mission was just to make sure that Tinkleton didn't do anything stupid.
Oh, then I would get a fate point. Because
mm-hmm.
mapping out resources for those who need was not completely accomplished.
Okay. So,
and I guess I didn't completely accomplish making Tinkleton do nothing stupid, because a lot of stupid
You tried,
shit.
But...
I tried
I
really
killed
hard.
Those snake eggs,
okay.
And you didn't stop me.
Okay.
I mean, that wasn't stupid, though.
No. I can't say that I would get a point for that, honestly.
Okay.
So.
Can I say I could get a point?
I mean, you'll still get a point, because you worked towards it, but didn't accomplish.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you worked towards it, but didn't accomplish it, you get a fate point.
I mean,
what
I did get
the did accomplish.
If you accomplish it, don't you get a persona point?
Yeah, the persona points are I'm doing after. I believe yes.
Okay.
If you have your character perform the action described in your instinct, you get a fate point.
Yeah.
So if you played your instinct.
Okay.
Yep.
I did.
I did not.
And I get one persona for the actually acting out my goal, right?
Accomplishing a goal earns you a persona point.
Cool.
I did because nobody got injured.
True. He didn't do anything. We totally rolled it.
I rolled so terribly with that snake. It was like one success, two
successes.
Okay,
that's pretty badass. What about other progression stuff?
Nobody played against their beliefs.
Nope.
Okay. MVP, most valuable player. You all decide this. One player. Who was the MVP, and they get a persona point.
It was probably Randall or Tinkleton.
I would have to go with Randall, because he was kind of like the group leader.
Okay.
And directed us. I'd probably have to say Randall.
Yeah, I sort of agree with that.
Yeah, let's see.
Certainly wasn't me.
MVP award goes to the player who made the crucial role so that the patrol could complete the mission.
Yeah, I think Randall probably.
Okay. Randall.
I vote the snake, actually.
The snake.
The snake made all the roles.
The snake made none of the roles ever. Okay.
They were all in our favor, though.
Majestic Raven also says the snake was MVP.
Snake was MVP. Okay. Workhorse. Sometimes one player carries the group through a lot of tough stuff. His character has all the right skills, and he makes all the roles to keep things moving. The Workhorse Award goes to a persona point. You can't be both the MVP and the Workhorse at once.
Tinkleton.
What?
He's a workhorse.
How is he the workhorse? I guess he's a workhorse.
Abernathy.
Well, I mean, I had the scout roles and stuff, but...
His job was to murder a fucking snake, and he did it. Tinkleton.
I guess
goes to Abernathy.
I'd have to do Abernathy, because he's the one that was able to find the snake.
I downvoted.
Alright, cool. Alright, I'll take it. Not saying I agree, but I'll take it.
Okay, and the last one is embodiment. This can be awarded to more than one person, but not everyone. It's if you roleplayed your character in a believable and entertaining manner throughout the entire session, you get a persona point.
Phoenix.
I think I was pretty much entertaining.
Yeah,
with
Phoenix was pretty good.
Okay, it can be awarded to more than one person, too. So.
I would go Tinkleton and Abernathy. And actually, you know what? I'd go all three of them except for me.
I don't know. You did your character well,
can't
too.
Be awarded to everybody.
Your character
with... Oh, it can't be awarded to everybody? Okay. I guess you've got the most so far, right? So
everybody, I have 3 fate and 3 personas.
Yeah.
Come at me, bro.
Okay.
I don't get any points for nothing.
I don't know. I thought your roleplay was good.
Your roleplay was good. So yeah. Abernathy, Allern, and Tinkleton get another persona point for roleplay. Because getting rewarded for roleplay is actually a mechanic in this.
Hell
I like
yeah.
It. And once that's all done, there you have it.
And that's it. Cool. And all the other progression is just based on like how many times we use skills and so forth.
Yep.
Blah blah blah.
Yeah, blah, blah.
Cool. Barry, you did an awesome job, sort of GMing us along. And what
it's
I'm
terribly rusty.
Well, it's fine. I mean, it's a one shot, right? What I'm hoping is that we can get more sort of like looks at other game types and so forth in these little one shots, and like maybe pick some games that we want to play like more consistently, maybe with different GMs and stuff, so that I don't always have to do it.
Yep.
In the future.
Lots.
And I think that Mouseguard is maybe Mouseguard has potential for that. And I mean, you know, that'll be based on Bear's schedule, basically. I know that right now she can't do it, but she was saying that she might do a longer-running Mouseguard game.
I love Tinkleton.
I say next couple that we try.
Yeah.
Don't rest your head.
Yeah.
I know you were super psyched for that.
I have that. Don't rest your head and Only War. I definitely want to give shots for.
Made RPG.
Okay, Phoenix.
Made RPG on my list.
I'm excited about that.
Champions is complicated, but it's great.
Is that the superhero one? Or?
It's a superhero hero system, yeah.
Okay, cool.
For a half an hour long game, or an hour, Everyone is John is fantastic.
Oh yeah, I've heard of Everyone is John. Yep. Yeah.
Paranoia is hilarious.
Okay, yeah, we have a couple of game systems that we can try. In fact,
Eclipse Phase.
In fact, you know, what time is it now? It's like 5
also
now.
The Call of Cthulhu.
I probably won't do another game session today, but I was thinking, like, if it's like, don't rest your head, I can do it in like 5 minutes. honestly, that's a really easy game to get into. But so we can try that. Only War, definitely going to try. And yeah, so hopefully the one-shot thing will be sort of a theme that we can kind of work on.
Yeah.
For now, I'm going to say, like, we'll turn stream off for a little bit. I'm probably going to be back with some video game stuff in, like, a half an hour. Or maybe I'll just jump into it straight away.
All right.
I don't know if anybody's interested in doing some, like, League of Legends or something like that. Like, just basic that we can get into right now.
Everyone is Jean.
But, yeah. So, thanks for watching, guys. And we'll continue the one-shots as they progress, sort of as they come out.